Welcome to this Simplifier tutorial. Today we will go through the process of creating a SAP system connection. With this connection we can call a function module via our built-in SAP RFC connector, which lets us read a list of SAP assets of a plant, which are called functional locations, and incorporate them into a Simplifier Fiori app. Before we start, let me give you an overview of the ways we can integrate SAP. We currently offer three different types of connectors. Native SAP RFC. RFC stands for Remote Function Call. SOAP Web Services. OData V2. In this tutorial, we will use the SAP RFC connector, which is our most used connector for SAP integration. Not only is it easy, simple, and versatile, but it also works with any SAP on-premise system, ensuring maximum integrability. To establish a successful connection to your SAP system, you need to know the following details: the IP address of the SAP application server, the instance number, the system ID, and optional, a SAP router or message server, the SAP username and password with respective permissions, and an open network connection to your SAP system. Before we can create a connector, we have to create a SAP system connection. For this, we open the SAP login mask. But be aware, the SAP application server needs to be reachable from your current Simplifier installation. So, consider to open firewalls and check other security measurements in your SAP network that might interfere with your access. Now let's start with going to the overview for connectors and clicking on the SAP system tab and create a new SAP system. First, we need to give our new SAP system a name and a description. The option for connection type is custom application server, which is already selected. In our case, the system ID is ID4. Copy and paste the instance number, 00. Fill in the client number, which for us is 800. For our system, we have a router to access it via internet. Copy and paste the router address. And last but not least, the IP address of the SAP application server itself. To set the default logon language, fill out the language field under Language tab. To finish the action, we click Save and Test so we can test the reachability. Note: if the SAP system is not reachable, either the address is wrong or the network cannot be reached. Great! Now we successfully created our system. Now let's create the backend authentication via a technical user. Go to the login overview and add a new login method. Create a new username and password login method. In our case, SAPD4 technical user, and fill out the associated authentication credentials. Okay. With all the prerequisites defined, we are now creating a new SAP RFC connector for reading a list of assets of a plant. In SAP terms, this is called functional locations. We are giving the connector the name SAP assets. For our active endpoint, we are choosing the custom option. We are selecting our SAP system. The connection pool is already configured correctly. For our login method, we are selecting our previously created login method. The SAP RFC connector uses the official SAP function for reading the list of assets. Our connector wizard automatically creates the connector call for said function module, which represents the operation of the data source. For that, we just need to search for the name of the needed function module bapi_funclock_getlist. The wizard guides you through the rest of the required steps. After creating the call, we need to test the call to ensure it works properly. We want to read all assets of our fictional plant in Munich. This plant has the ID 1000. So we add a new selection parameter with the option EQ, which stands for equal. The ID of the plant has to be set as the parameter low, and the sign needs to be I for include. With all the required parameters set, we can now test our connector call. Great, it works. We successfully got the list of our assets back. Thank you for watching this tutorial. See you in the next one. Stay awesome.